Welcome back to Take Apart. Today, I will show you how to replace rear brake pads on Hyundai or Kia with electronic parking brake. Easy and at home, with no scanner or OBD tools needed. This is Hyundai i30 from 2019. It has 100,000 kilometers on clocks. And recently, I cleaned brake discs and noticed that rear brake pads are in bad shape. Make sure to subscribe. As you can see, here is wire for electronic motor that is attached to the caliper. Do not disconnect the connector, or else you will end up with the light on dashboard. I'll push piston bit inside and unscrew these two screws holding caliper on place. They are for 14mm socket. On the end of the video, I'll show you what to do after you finish this job. And sometimes you need to hold them with 17mm spanner. Now you can remove caliper easily. Do not damage wire or brake line. Here are the old pads. They have these spring bars attached to them. They are a bit rusty, but still usable. Now I will remove the pads. They are really stuck there. Rust is number one enemy for these brakes. Alright, now here are steel plates that I will have to clean and reuse. For cleaning, I'm using wire brush. It should be enough. This is first brake change since car was new. Now I'll clean contact places as well. Again, it is not too bad, so wire brush is sufficient. Next, I'll move to these locating pins. You really want to make sure they are free to move and they have a lubricant on them. Those are vital parts for brakes. Now, here is the elephant in the room. Electronic motor attached to the caliper. It is held there with two screws. If I'm correct, 4mm Allen key will do the job. These screws have quite a lot of tread lock on them. As you can see, I soaked them in penetrating oil. Here we go. Now you can separate plastic motor housing from caliper. Easy, right? Make sure to subscribe. Grab a 6mm Allen key and turn clockwise this shaft or bolt until it stops. Do not force it. When it stops, it stops. Perfect. Make sure rubber gasket is clean and lubricated. Push in piston to create space for new brake pads. You can do it by hands. It is not most pleasant experience, but it works. Now you can attach electronic motor on caliper with connector facing up. Screw in two screws and tie them just enough. Housing is plastic, do not over tie them. I always put a little bit of grease on contact points. I hope it will keep things rust free for a bit longer. Be careful, as last thing you want to drip grease on your new pads or discs. I got these TRW pads for great price, so it was no brainer for me. Two pads with steel things are supposed to be inside. Again, little bit of grease on contact points and they can go in. Let me know in comments below what would you like to see next, or go check my other videos. I love grease, been on piston and on claws of the caliper. Spring bars can go back in the pads. Brake pads have holes where you can stick them like so. Perfect. Caliper can go back in too. As you see, those spring bars are working as caliper is flexing. Tighten two screws with 14mm socket. If so, you can use 17mm spinner to hold pin if spinning. All done. Last step is to get rid of gap between the pads and discs. I'll show you that on the end of the video. Make sure to check brake fluid level, as it will rise due to compressed pistons in rear calipers. My one has still room to rise. Alright. I'll do the same on other side and then we will jump inside and finish the job there. Let's go inside. Press few times brake pedal to get rid of the gap between the pads and discs. And check, I have a new clean glove, so no dirty fingerprints in the car. Pull on handbrake switch, you will hear motor working for unusually long time. That is normal, as it adjusting itself to new pads. Release handbrake and repeat several times. It should sound normal now. So we have managed to do the job successfully, and as you can see, there is no light on dashboard. Thanks for watching and see you next time.